Hello my convicts, yes it's me aka the Kappa Convict bringing you another video guys. So we've done some Battlefield 1 which I do apologize, I wanted to upload that yesterday but I thought I'd do it today but I wanted to do this as well. Now as you can see we're using Phantom. Now Phantom was a character I kind of didn't really like, I wasn't too bothered about him, I thought he's a character. I never really used him with his first abilities, but dang, his other abilities are pretty tank. So let's show you some of these new abilities that he can do on here. So as we all knew, there was active camo. Now this renders you almost invisible. You literally are like liquid. You look like liquid when you're running around. It's really, really cool. It actually lasts a long time. This lasts a long time. It does. It must last about, I think, between 7 and 10 seconds. It does last pretty long, not like it does for Spectre, which was like 3 or 4 seconds. This actually, you can run around and almost get across an entire map while in active camo. So that is a pretty interesting perk. Pulsar, I've always liked this one because it basically tells you where every single person is on the map. You can literally spin around and see no matter where they are, up level, lower level, you can see them. Now obviously there is a counter to Pulsar, but it is still a really good perk. I've not really seen many people use the counter for this. I do use it myself, but I've never really seen too many people actually use that particular counter. I will tell you what that is as well, because why not? But the other senses we've got on here, or perks or traits, whatever they want to call them, is heightened senses. Now, I don't quite get this one. This is the only one I'm not too sure on. I've tried using it. It's what I'm going to use because mark target is okay. Rear guard is okay. But I wanted to try heightened senses out because apparently it gives you an audio cue. If someone is to move fast or is aerial, so he's jumping, I'd be able to hear them, and if I'm getting lower to the ground it would increase that range of detection. So obviously if I'm doing the whole sniper thing laying down, it should increase it. Now don't believe you need to have an actual sniper rifle to do this, so I'm not too sure on that, but I'm flipped between this on marked target and heightened senses. Obviously marked target, if I hit them, go behind cover, it gives me a chance to obviously get a kill on them because they can't regenerate their health for 5 seconds. So that's a pretty interesting good trait, I think, for Phantom. I think if I was to pick, I would definitely pick Pulsar, and I would definitely pick probably marked target at the moment. But we're going to keep on trying heightened senses. I also want to show you active camo as well because it's pretty tank. But also, I want to show you the heads. Now, we've got quite a few new heads, as you can see here. And I thought, why not share it with you guys? So that's the Granite. Then you've got Wildwood, which kind of looks like a freaky scarecrow-y kind of look. You've got the, obviously, normal one that we know him as. The white one, obviously snow level, multicam. We've got sand dune, and we've got mantis. Now mantis seems to be my favorite at the moment, but I'm kind of liking wildwood as well, and I do like sand dune because it, especially for sand dune, you can't see the face. So if someone goes to shoot at you, they're gonna have to shoot for the hat and not actually the face itself, because you won't be able to see it as easy as obviously something like that. You can easily see him and shoot him in the face. For that one, that is quite covered, quite dark, so that would probably be one of the kind of outfits I like using because of it's not easy to actually see. That I really do like because it reminds me of the Predator. I'm sorry, but it does. It reminds me of the Predator. They should have called it Predator, not Mantis. We've got Wildwood, which is cool as well. And they're the only ones I've got at the moment. I ain't got any from the Quartermaster as of yet. So it'll be interesting to see what they are as well, because I really want to see what that is. Retro ghillie. That's probably the ghillie suit, possibly. You know, with the whole leaves all over the head, possibly. So, and we haven't got no new bodies as of yet, because you've got to do certain things with his abilities. So you've got to get kill two enemies while using a single activation of Pulsar. So you have to use Pulsar and kill two enemies at the same time. You've got to kill two enemies 10 times. You've got to get 50 melee kills. You've got to get 10 kills after they damage your rear guard, so you've got to get someone to shoot you in the back, spin round, kill them, which I've nearly done. We're up to 9 of 10 of that. But yeah, I am enjoying it. It's really good. But there's one thing I wanted to do this video about, which is it is titled, and that is about this. It's called the Hailstorm Void. Wow, this gun is insanely good. It's a free burst weapon, but my god, it absolutely melts them to the floor. It is one of my favorite guns. I use this all the time. If I run out of bullets, I'm like, hey, it don't matter, boy. It don't matter. I've got my Hailstorm because it is that good. It literally is. So I'm going to do some gameplay. The HVR, I've got the rare version of the Atlas. I still kind of don't like this gun. It's not very consistent. Still not as consistent as I want it to be. It just seems that you're taking anyone who's not really up close, you're going to die. So if they're mid-range, you're going to die. If they're further than that, you've got no chance. You've got to be pretty close when using this weapon. So this is more a run in your face and shoot them down sort of weapon. But the gun of choice I've been really enjoying at the moment is the Volk, strangely enough. I hated this when I first got it because of not having detachments. But I'm using ELO, foregrip and quick draw with the perks such as Dead Silence, Momentum, Dexterity and Ghost. And it is beast. So without further ado, guys, let's get it on and show you some gameplay. So I'm going to add a camo onto this. We'll go with the scratches, make it look old. There we go. I'm tempted to actually put a sight on this because, as you can see, I've been doing quite a fair bit with it. No, we'll leave it as it is for now. So let's jump into a game and let's show you the Hailstorm. Just itch my nose before we start. So as you can see, we're almost ranked to the full rank, and then we can naturally prestige our character. I don't know why, but the connection's been a bit slow. As you can see, it's taken a while to find people. But even on Black Ops 3, I went on Black Ops 3, I thought, should I do a Black Ops 3 gameplay for you guys today? I could not get in the lobby at all. I had, what, 3 people in the lobby, and that was it. And that's all I could seem to get was just 2-3 people. So is Black Ops 3 already dead? Is everybody loving Infinity Warfare more? I don't know, but it was really weird. I was uploading at the time, so I have to give them that, possibly because I was uploading, it was slowing my connection down too much to be able to obviously get that, but dang. So let me just have a quick drink. Wet the whistle. Right, so we're going against Warfighters, Synaptic, Warfighters, Synaptic. Okay. So we're going to use the Volk, but we're not going to use that. We're going to use, obviously, its counterpart, the Hailstorm. That's a free burst weapon, and you can only do 3 bursts each time. But if you are accurate, you'll love this gun, because this gun just absolutely dominates. It's like my babe's gun, the Annihilator pistol. As we all know, she's my babe. I absolutely love Seraph to death. Most beautiful woman ever. What's this guy doing? Don't know. But look at that. One burst. One burst and he's gone. And I'm using Dexterity so I can reload faster. So, but that this gun is insane. I just love this gun. Put a few more attachments on, this would be an absolute beast of a gun. I would recommend obviously running around with Scavenger for this, because it will run out, but it's pretty dang quick. But look at that. He had no chance of beating me. I just outbeat him like he was nothing. And it's pretty accurate. You don't really need a sight on it. There's not really much else I can say. It's just too good. And you're probably wondering, why am I running back and forth? Sorry, I'm talking to you guys. I tend to not concentrate as well when I'm talking. So I will shut up now and let's concentrate. Okay, that's a teammate. Okay, we've got a guy over there. Go on, chase me, I dare you. Thank you. Okay, I had no clue. Nope, you're dying. Oh, I did miss the shot. I did miss. You have to not miss with this gun. If you do miss, there is a chance you can get a kill, but if they're pretty good aim, you are going to probably die. But I'm still liking the gun. I did not have a clue where he was. I did not know where he was. Okay, he was halfway up the building. At least I could hear him, but I wasn't too sure where he was. Now this is active camo, so let's use active camo. And just because he can still see him. Let's see if this guy notices me. Nope. So there we go. One to the back of the head. Now apparently if you get melee kills, you do get another outfit. So we'll try and do that. But it has to be a melee kill. So my best option is to get behind him and hit them in the back. Because it only takes one hit from the back.
Friendly scarab active.
Okay.
We've lost the lead.
Okay, that's the teammate behind me. It was making me worry then. Okay, so there's a guy around here somewhere. Get him, boys. Okay. Don't get him.
Enemy UAV.
Go on, buddy, you go first. Thank you. Okay. That's where it's probably not going to work. Because it is slightly ranged. You do need to be not as close. But if you're about mid-range, then you're okay. If I put a long barrel on, possibly it might work better. I saw him rewind, but fair enough.
UAV in your vicinity.
I wasn't too sure what was going on there, to be honest.
The enemy is halfway there.
Okay.
Take them down.
I need to get my aim on, because my aim's gotten a little bit at the moment. Okay, I'm trying to. Okay, so we got one hit on him. Okay, come and get him now. Whoa! No. As you see, even payload can't beat this gun in a gunfight. But yeah, just try and keep mid to close range with this. If you put long barrel on, possibly you could probably get away with that. But at the moment, because I don't have that on, you want to be pretty damn close in order to get those kills. There we go. Now let's disappear. Can you see me? Can you see me, bro? Oh, okay. My aim was a little bit wonky. And he did jump on. I must have just shot under his foot, possibly, but. What happened there? Did I get. I must have got hit in the back. No? Okay. It sounded like I got hit. Maybe he punched me at some point, I don't know.
Friendly drone support is active.
Just changed my gun again.
Friendly scarab active. Friendly scarab active.
Yeah, he's too far. I'm gonna have to do this for this guy. Get out. Come and chase me. I'll say you come and get me. Go on, you know you want to come and get me. Okay, I got one. I was just waiting for his boyfriend, but I don't know. Is he dead? Okay, just get a quick reload. I felt like I did hit one shot on him at least. But I don't know. Maybe I didn't, but I did feel like one shot did him. Nope. Okay. Fair enough. Teammate couldn't help me there. If my teammate had helped me there, we could have probably survived that. As I was too busy shooting someone. Nope. You die, buddy. Sorry.
Friendly drone support is active.
Just get a quick reload in. Nope. Oh, shooting through his legs. The one issue with Synaptic. If you shoot at his legs, it just doesn't seem to register. So I'll never shoot for Synaptic's legs. Always go for the upper body.
Friendly scarab active.
Because you will die enemy if you don't. Well, okay. Just use the rewind, as you can see there. That was the rewind. No. Nobody. You can die as well, thank you. Okay, I'm gonna use the... my other gun just for a minute, because these guys are a bit further back than I want them to be. I thought I killed him. He must have literally been one shot, if that. That's how close he is to death. And there we go. So we went 19-12 in this gameplay. So we'll show you another gameplay with the Hailstorm, because it is a good weapon. What I might actually do is I might take off the perks of the other gun and just use the pistol and see how we do with that, because I don't want to be swapping over, but I do need scavenger on for this kind of particular gun, because obviously you don't want to run out of bullets that fast. But I want to try a different sight, maybe try a long barrel as well, see if that will improve that range. Because I'm always trying to improve on my classes, so we'll take that off and we'll put on that and we'll have... quick draw, long barrel. Change momentum for scavenger. And that leaves one perk left. If I take that off, because I don't really need that on, I could go for hollow point or laser sight. We'll try laser sight. Because as you can see, with the sights on this gun, they are pretty clear, so you can easily see what you're supposed to be doing on there. But there we go, guys. What a weapon. And there's the Centurion ammo on that. I might put the Centurion on there. As you can see, with the Void as well, because it's common, all it does is readiness, which reload fast when the mag is empty. So you can actually use all your weapon, use all your ammo. And because I've got Dexterity on, it means that I will reload extra fast with this gun, so you don't have to worry too much about reloading, to be honest. I do it anyway because I like to be ready, but you don't generally need to if you've got readiness on as well. But when we're thinking about active camo is okay. It's okay. Let me just mute this guy. Shush, everyone, shush. Active camo is okay. But it just takes a long time to find someone. I just find that the other perk, where you can see people through walls, is much better. Because obviously you can see them, you know where everyone is, and you can get into position to kill someone. Or if someone's very close, you know exactly where they're going to be. It just makes for a much better choice to use if you want to use that. Okay. Not bad at that. Just gonna do a bit of wall running. Oh. This guy gonna chase me? Probably won't. There we go. See you later, buddy. But as you can see, that was one burst. I killed him in one burst. I did shoot out two. Nope, can't get that guy. But look how fast it reloads. Nope. One burst, look. This gun is insane. It's my fun gun. I love this gun. I am loving this. My babe would love to use this gun. Look at that. My babe would love this gun. And now Seraph, if you're wondering. She would love this gun. Oh. Look at that. And now we've got a drone package and counter UAV, so put counter up. Now the big question is, where can I put this? Let's put it there. That's it. You help me out, buddy. Come on, drop it quick. There we go. It's a Scarab. Okay. And if you're wondering, out of the care packages what I've got so far, I've actually got an advanced UAV. I have got a Warden. But generally, I've got a shock sentry and a few scarabs. So I've actually been doing all right. I've been doing okay for, you know, for the stuff you get out of care packages. So they're not bad. They're not bad. But also, guys, put in the comments below what should I unlock when I reach 55? What do you want me to unlock? Let me know in the comments below, guys, and I'll choose it. Now someone close. Look, there's these guys here. Not even got a clue I'm here. Where's this guy gone? Just punch that guy in the face. Whoa! Oh, okay. Fair enough. You got me. Probably a bad place to do this, but hey, there you go. Nah, buddy. Right, I'm gonna go this way.
The enemy is halfway there. Take them down.
Okay. Nope. I don't think so, buddy. Try again. This gun. I'm definitely sure they will nerf this gun at some point because it is this good. It's just unfortunate my team are not very good. I should hand them all out hailstorms. Maybe they'll do better. No, this guy behind me. I could hear feet. But it's my teammate. Scaring me. No, my aim. I did miss. Fair enough, I did miss. Have you got him? No? Nope. You're not using my gun against me, boy. As you can see, the guy tried to use my gun against me. Nobody. Let's try the hipfire. Let's see what the hipfire is like. Because I have got laser sight on. Let's see what it's like. Active camo. Who can we punch today? We'll go for this guy. There you go. I don't know if that guy was playing, but dang, it just stood there. Okay, so long barrel even with that on, yeah, I don't know. We'll try it again. I'm just testing it out, so if I may die a little bit, just to test out some features. Let's try the hipfire. Okay. Okay. hip fire is pretty tank. Okay, I think I missed that. It looked like it was more to his right. Remember, you've got to get the white arrows to be pointing at him if you're going to hipfire. Okay, back off a minute. Just heal a moment. I'm going to aim for this one. Now, he's head glitching behind something, so I'm going to go around him. Possibly that was a hipfire. Not really being as good, but we'll try it again. Okay, got an assist. I'll probably say it's better to aim this weapon at the moment. But I wouldn't say I'm the best hipfire anyway, to be honest. Possibly if I aimed, I could have probably outbeat that guy then. Let's go back to aiming now, because hipfire is not too bad, but you do have to be pretty close, I think, for hipfire. Okay. Who can I hit today? Who can I hit today? Dum, 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 dum. I'm gonna hit you today. There we go. So we went 18 and 9 in this gameplay. So unfortunately we didn't win. We was close. We did get close. But there you go. The Hailstorm. Wow. What a gun that is. That is an insane weapon. Now the hipfire, for me, it's a little bit inconsistent. I've not really practiced with it that much though, so I can only say try it out for yourself, guys, on the hipfire. The long barrel kind of increases it a little bit, but I wouldn't say a great deal. As you can see, I'm using 4/3. I just seem to feel that 4/3 is nice for me. That's a nice area to be in. It seems to be good enough to aim and get those head glitches, and enough to move left and right as well. So that's kind of feeling my feeling of sensitivity as well. Use 4/3 if you're like me and do a lot of aiming, and it does pretty okay. There might be sometimes you might get outbeat if someone slides, but it's on a very rare occasion on that. So just to show you as well the counter, because I was just saying obviously before, like pulsar and active camo. So if you go on here, if you use hardwired, as you can see, that will actually counter pulsar. So if you're using hardwired, it will block out pulsar. So you would need to use that in order to be able to block that out. If you're cold-blooded, you can block out the other perk that people use, which is perception with FTL. And ghost, obviously, ping, relay, anything like that will help you out with that. And blind eye will obviously block out all these shock sentries and everything. And there you go. So that's it, guys. That's all I want to show you today. Some beast gameplay from the Hailstorm pistol. It is an absolute smasher of a weapon. It is brilliant. It is the variant of it, but even the base variant of this weapon was pretty dang good. Well, I hope you enjoyed, guys. If you did, don't forget to smash that thumbs up button. It does help my channel to grow. And this is your boy, Kappa, signing out. And as always, I salute you. See you next time.